Good morning, guys. Lillian with Lily Ray's Collection. Today I am going to paint on a canvas panel. Arteza was having a great sale on these. This is 100% cotton and it was a pack of 14. So I thought that that was a steal. I bought one package to try them out and see what happens. Not sure what I'm going to do on it today, but I did want to test it out and see how things come out. Now, I was debating what medium to use. It is a canvas. I do have to prime it. Let me see. Even though it says, let me see, Arteza canvas surface is ready for any kind of oil, acrylic paint, and other wet or dry mediums. Our premium grade canvas panels are the perfect choice for light paint application practice studies. So, I'm really interested to see if I can do, it says wet. I'm going to leave this on, I guess. Watercolor on it. Oh boy. I'm always leery. But I guess I'm not going to prep it because it says that it's prepped. So, let me get... I want to use... I'm going to use my Derwent intense paints. And these colors are permanent colors. Once you lay them down, they should move. So I have my own little swatch on 140-pound cardstock watercolor paper. And then this is theirs. So that is that. Okay, now. Let me go ahead and wet these. I hope that I'm in camera here. I didn't put on my, I did not put on my PC where I could see what I'm doing. Well, let's see what happens. I love, love, love these. Now, let me grab, I know I could do it with a water brush, but I don't think I'm going to be using a water brush. I have no idea what I'm going to paint. Nada. Let me grab something and I'll be right back. All right, so I sketched everything onto the canvas, and now we are going to paint it. I have Sorrento Artist Loft, and this is a spotter brush, which I'm going to use for the very small details. And this is a number 3. It says 3/0, and my Mimic Creative Mark, number 12 round. And this one is a 3/4 flat. And this is just to wet everything at once. And these are from Jerry Artorama. From Jerry's Artorama. Okay. I sprayed my palette. Where's my water? Here. I'm going to spray that because I want this to be loose, and it's the first time that I'm working on a panel, so let's see what happens. Okay. should I do? Splatters. Let's see how this is going to dry. It's the first time I'm working on this, so I don't know what to expect. And then we're going to do some pink. Maybe it's not wet enough. Oh, there it is. Let's put some on the flower. I do have a rag here. All right, and now I'm going to start with her . Okay, this is too big to work with, so I'm going to use the number 12. And what colors do I want? Well, let's do her skin tone. I'm going to do her the typical skin tone. And whatever I need to leave white, I'm going to leave white. And if this doesn't work out, I'll go over it with gesso and do it again. Okay, so I'm going to do, this is Sienna with okra. And a little bit of blue, because her skin is pretty dark. Okay, maybe I should just do her whole face this color. Let's see if I could wipe this, because this is pretty wet. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to dab her nose, dab her forehead. I don't know if I have to dry it within in between layers. Well, let me do her ears. Okay, now let me jump over to her flat, to the flower. I want to make her a purple. Oh, that's blue. Okay, so we're going to use that blue. And where's my... Okay, so here's the white. That means this one. 1, 2, 3, 4 is the purple. Yep. Put some on the flower. So let's see. There's nothing like experimenting on camera. I'm gonna just pink. Which I believe is this one, fuchsia. Let's see, yep. I'm gonna just add it. Let that wick out. Okay, well, we are at the final stage. I have completed my Frida, a young Frida. I love the way she came out. I love that painterly look. And it's my first time using the canvas panel, but it won't be the last because it was really, really excellent to work on. Very, very forgiving. So I will be posting this. If anyone is interested, please let me know. Take care.